This is Raid Fox 37.
Earth Day 76.
And we're back to playing Secret of Mana. We are going to head to the Empire now, and we're going to go through the south to South Town, go through the underground waterway, grind for a bit, and then see if we can rescue Dialect. So,
yeah,
wish us luck.
And in honor of us being in the desert in game and in real life, yours truly is bringing the hotness with my short shorts. Who wears short shorts? I does.
I wear short shorts.
Damn.
Oh, good. We did get it all done. Okay. Just wanted to double check there. All right. So time to cannon travel it.
Yes, I did.
To the Empire. Try to keep a low profile when you're, while you're in the Empire. Just pop yourself in the barrel. So little sister's coming home tonight. We'll probably be home around 6 or 7, and we're going to do my new RP creation, Doom Life, which is a combination of Half-Life and Doom 3. So super special, awesome, excited for that.
It's going to be a wonderful and exciting time for you, Mrs. Freeman.
I love this song. This is my favorite town in the game here.
Good memories.
This is the Empire's lauded South Town.
Ooh, we're gonna see Cherry Bogard.
Look, it's the Queen of South Town! Stupid dub.
And there's life in the old boy yet.
Billy Kane! I just gotta listen to the song real quick here. I prefer the original more, but this is still okay. It's not as bad as the butchering they did to the Republic song.
Now, you want to talk about a bad remix? Try the PS1 Mega Man X remake. Woohoo, was the music shit compared to the SNES?
Huh. You'd think it wouldn't because it's a CD, you know, based system. Alright, here's the original here. Oh, whoops.
Yeah, I kind of like the slower, more melodic one.
That Mar woman is a little off. I'd still steer clear of her if I were you. Mar's always carrying around that little box. I wonder if she keeps her treasures in there. Alright, so here's one of the only two buildings in town here. So this is the inn. And then upstairs is the item shop. Now we're going to... Normally, you don't have to get this equipment here. But we're going to do the fact that the sewers can be a little tricky. So, you know, plus we've got the money, so, you know, might as well. Let's see, I'm just going to restock on a couple items here. Especially those because that fire palace was an asshole to us. So, alright, so unfortunately, the boy can't get a new hood, but the girl can, which is, the sprite can. I think we already have one of those, but I think I was an idiot and I sold it. So let me double check here. Oh, I didn't sell it. Thank goodness. Okay. So that saves us, some money there. So let me just get this equipped for the sprite there. Because I remember I did pick, we did pick up one from the Robin's Foot that over in the Fire Palace. So just have to get one for the chick.
That's right, honey. I got a Shantae.
Then we're going to get 3 Ruby Vests. And then 3 Golem Rings.
Golem number 9. Very interesting Japanese band, if I may say so.
Alright, so we'll go ahead and sell all this here. I sold my raccoon cap like an idiot. Okay, I'll buy another one, it's all good. Okay, so we're going to put the ring on, which will raise the defense to 51, evade to 24, magic defense to 37. Ruby Vest jumps you up 94 defense, 61 evade, and 71 magic defense. And then I got to get my raccoon cap back, so let me do that real quick here.
You know, Sam, was it...
I know I said this last time, but Davey Trumpet, King of the Wild Frontier. You know, how old am I that I still remember that shit?
So that brings the boys' defense to 115, evade to 84, and magic defense to 92. So we're going to earn the spray. A bolted hood.
Oh, he's already got one.
Oh, yeah, that's right. So we got the Golem Ring. So that'll bring Sprite up to defense of 103, evade of 83, and a magic defense of 90. Now all that's left is the girl power.
Okay, let's see. Let's see me fuck this up this time. Okay, I've now got a 54, 31, 64. No, those are not my real measurements. Ooh, she's getting to be a big girl now. And last but not least... Oh, that's right, baby. G cups.
That brings the girl's defense to 110, evade to 83, and magic defense to 110. She usually gets the highest magic defense, and you're cool, man. Don't worry about it. Okay, go ahead and exit out there. All right, so we're equipped for the sewers. So all we have to do now is we have to go over to Mara's house, basically the girl they're talking about. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a quick little rest here. Just to see if anything happens.
Yeah. Remember how when Anita Sarkeesian said girls get worse stats than boys in video games? Ha ha ha! Bullshit! Yeah, if you notice those stats, both of them are getting comparatively higher stats all around than the guy. I guess main character syndrome can't save you every time.
Alright, so we're all safe there.
No thought studio for you.
I like the town because I like the color of the grass and just like how it's got a wall in the middle of it and everything. I think that's really cool.
Yeah.
So Mara sees us and goes inside. So we follow.
Yeah, let's talk to the creepy cat lady.
Oh, I know who you are.
You're Gemma's
friend. See, I'm actually a Taznikan spy undercover here in the Empire. Boy, she looks really, really decrepit. So was my husband until he got caught with sensitive information on continuing his work. I swear I'll avenge his death if it's the last thing I do. Enter NorthTown from the sewer passageway east of here. The resistance uses it to infiltrate the city. Give the guard the secret number 634. It's the only way he'll let you through. So, basically, NorthTown is our next destination. We're going to meet up with the resistance who's fighting the Empire. Unfortunately, it's not Antifa, so we're grateful there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, if it was Antifa, then everybody would be fucked.
Southtown's not as big as NorthTown, that is true. NorthTown's a pretty big city. It's going to be the biggest one in the game. You look suspicious, don't we catch you loitering? Ready?
Yeah, but NorthTown doesn't have the Bogart brothers, you know what I'm saying?
I know what you're saying.
You only get to hear them Blue Mary Blues if you go to Southtown, baby.
Alright. Sewer's over in this direction.
And yes.
Right around the wall, and there's a guy that just, like, runs up to go guard the gate.
And yes,
now, if you go see him earlier, he's going to tell you to go away. But now that we talked to Mara... Think you know the secret code? Try it. Even if you know the secret code, he won't do this until you talk to Mara. So we got 6, 3, and 4. 6, 3, 4. And he doesn't say enter. Okay, here we go. 6, 3, 4. 6, 3, 4. That's so loud. Fucking idiot box. Okay, so now we're going to go inside the sewers, so we're going to be battling Dino Fish and Blue Drops, so this is a little tricky, just to let you know.
Damn it, Fox, you just created a time paradox.
Oh, Adrian Shepherd did.
Well, damn it, now we're going to have to retcon the whole franchise.
Oh, dear. I went through the portal trying to chase after Gordon Freeman, and I created a trying to create a paradox.
Damn it, now
which
we're
gonna... actually happens in Opposing Force if you get jumped in after Freeman.
Well, now we're gonna have to give Class A amnestics to everybody. Nice going, Fox.
Yeah.
You know what the old Five Council's gonna do to you now, right? Now you're gonna have to work with Jack Bright.
And what's really tough is that they cast Acid Storm, which shoots through your defense, which can make this a little tricky. These can see, as you can see there. And we whack the fuckers, so there we go. And here's the ye old Blue Drops that we know and love.
Where's the dragon? Where's the hero from Dragon's Quest when you need him?
A slime draw is near.
good times, my friend. Good times.
Yeah. Oh, I totally whipped that.
That's it.
There we go. And I'm frosted. Yippee. Very nice.
Oh.
Ah, and I ran right into the fucking wall with that one. And they divided again. Awesome.
This is what happens when you're out, goddammit.
I'm just gonna back away from everybody.
You can't!
I hate it when they have Wolverine powers.
No kidding.
You've got an army, I've got bullshit. Welcome to Marvel Comics. Oh! Respect my authority, bitches.
God damn it. Alright, well, we're gonna... something happens.
I got one of them.
Yes, you did, but yeah. Oh, Golden Tiara, very cool. Alright, we're just gonna bail at this point.
Yeah, fuck that noise.
We're gonna transport a snowman with us, dude. Alright, so here's the little duck guys.
DuckTales.
We're gonna go ahead and take out the blue drop first, man.
Okay.
Very cool.
Ow. Alright, I'm gonna heal you.
Heal us all.
God damn it, I keep forgetting. Damn it, Ardith, you were making progress.
I missed, of course. And I keep getting barraged, yes. Gotta love it. Alright, I got healed, fortunately. I was about to say, watch, I'm gonna become a ghost soon.
Son of a... Oh, goddamn. I almost had a full level 4 charge.
Yay, thank you very much, Mr. Sprite. They got this stupid dino fish. Yeah, like I said, this place is a little tricky, but I'm glad that we got the upgraded armor there, because we desperately needed that. And it's a little tough to navigate. In the Super Nintendo, it's very difficult to navigate. Yeah, especially if you're playing with just a computer, or just some computer-controlled characters. Ugh.
Yeah, I can give you a bad flashback to that factory level in RE5 with Sheva Alomar when you're by yourself. Sheva, Chris, Sheva, Chris, Sheva, Chris. Yeah, I'm sorry.
Wow.
Well, you know, that ass, man. That West African ass.
Cool, we're going to this. So yeah, once we get to NorthTown and after we're done exploring and gearing up and everything like that, we're going to go grind a bit over at the castle. We got to get our spells up to level 4, basically. And we'll gain some levels and some gold that way, too, which is perfect.
But right now, we just need to kill all the things so we can piss off Kida. And oh, maybe Ted Turner while we're at it.
I'm looking the wrong way. Oh,
wind,
grass. Oh, well.
Water, fire, earth, Venus, go planet. Yeah, I'm sorry, but anybody who marries Jane Fonda is full of metric Costco-sized piles of bullshit.
Die. Yeah. Very nice, alright. Let's get these fuckers down here.
Sorry.
No!
Yeah, I did it too earlier.
No!
No!
Trying to get you to level 29 now, man.
Yeah, the no heard all over the world. You are the chosen one, Annie. You were supposed to defeat Darth Disney, not join him.
Darth Disney.
Unlimited copyright infringement. You know, I'm gonna laugh so hard if in the next movie it turns out they're not bringing back Palpatine. It's actually Mickey Mouse as Darth Disney.
Oh boy! Get the fuck up!
Who said you could leave the rape dungeon? And really, would it surprise anybody if Mickey did have one?
This is a snuggle dungeon!
Oh, and for those of you who might be interested in some very obscure and potentially uninteresting information about copyright infringement in Disney, there was a character added to, I believe it was the House of Mouse on the Disney Channel called Mortimer Mouse, who was supposed to be kind of like the evil corporate brother of Mickey Mouse. Well, fun fact, the person who created Mortimer Mouse first was actually the cartoonist of the series Bloom County, Berkeley Brevet, and he created him about a good 10 years before Disney did. Yeah, can anybody say lawsuit? But I think we all know why he isn't suing Disney. Just, you know, people who cross the mouse tend to disappear.
So he made it to the resistance here. That's a fast. Who are you, Imperial Spies? No, 634, 634! Oh, you're that soldier with that gem at the ensemble we have on lookout for. Welcome to the Resistance. Nice to meet you. I'm Fox. What's at the proper act all of a sudden? Ah, jealous. Alright, so if you know I'm only interested in dialect. Whoa, you know dialect? Of course, why? Have you heard of the rumors east of the town? Supposedly there's a man there they named dialect for stealing people's life energy. That's what happened in Pandora, but why would dialect... Something must be controlling him. I'll make sure the resistance looks into it. So, yeah, no way to not give us your name. Good luck, and their name's Chrissy. Chrissy's dad saw us found the resistance, but the Empire got him in the end. The resistance fit a beast upon a crook, but Chrissy stepped up and replaced her father. She's only 18, but we all depend on her. Chrissy's our leader. Thank you. The Empire used to be such a peaceful nation. All this trouble started about 15 years ago, I reckon.
Oh, Chrissy, you're so fine. You're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Chrissy.
Yeah. Chrissy had to grow up so too fast. This age, I'm sure she just wanted a normal childhood. And I always wondered if he could get down there, but of course he can. Thanks for going to the next screen. But anyway.
Oh, sorry.
The Emperor entrusts his four generals with most military matters. Sheikra is the leader, plus there's guest star, the mech rider, and Vanna, the strongest woman in the Empire's army. And last but not least, Thanatos, the mystic knight. That's all I know, sorry!
Please don't kill me or rob me blind.
Oh yeah, you can't go that way in this one. The Emperor's troops are searching for this secret base. Those rooms sure are part popular these days. Who knows what those humans over there are doing? And you can't go behind the counter in this one, unfortunately.
I know.
Trying to talk to the chickie there, but you can't talk to the chickie.
Damn it. And I wanted to buy some.
Oh, there we go. Ooh. Now we can. Take your time. Okay, thank you. Yeah, we sure did trying to get around there. I forgot you could do that. All's cleared. Hook 2, 3, 4, or 3, 5. I'm playing war like that old army man. Yeah, good for you. So now there's the first floor, and it's a cafe. The cafe's a friend for the resistance's base. Pretty clever, huh? Not really. I've heard Christy crying at night. Look at the sign. Touch the plane. And now, out we go into NorthTown.
No, you fool. Don't touch the flame. You'll become the main protagonist of Dark Souls.
I lost my father in the Battle for Republic 15 years ago. So basically, this is NorthTown here. It's more... See, my wife, she's acting strange all of a sudden, wandering out of the house and says, "Where are you?" So it's pretty much more urban than SouthTown is, obviously.
Yep.
Oh yeah, there's a little slip you can go through somewhere here. Oh no, I'm thinking Gold City. Yeah, I'm thinking Gold City, never mind. Okay. So basically there used to be like a tree that you could walk through around this area here too. There's a little boy here. I'm telling Mama, okay. Oh, you little shit. Yeah, relax, we're not Harvey Weinstein.
I know,
or
right?
Or Jerry Epstein. Empire's claim stretches from this town to SouthTown and Gold Island. Alright, so we're gonna go buy some new armor now.
You fool, you're not supposed to tell the tourists about El Dorado.
Welcome, what'll it be? So here, we're gonna get Tiger equipment.
Tiger!
So first we'll get the three frosty rings. Then we'll get the tiger bikini for her, tiger two-piece for the chick. Bikini, of course. Two tiger suits, which are just so adorable.
The bikini was tiger stripes.
Tiger caps.
Tiger upper, tiger knee.
Tiger!
Alright, so we'll sell the golem rings. So, like I said, short-lived equipment. So it's good to have to sell and it help get us through the tours, basically. So. And we pick the golden tiara up on the way for some extra gold, which is cool. So now we equip tiger cap, frosty ring, tiger suit. So that brings my defense to 139, a main to 84, magic defense to 115. Now we're going to do the equipment for the sprite here. He's going to wear the bikini. So that brings his defense to 122, evade to 82, and magic defense to 107.
It's almost like a Calvin skinned Hobbs, and now he's wearing them.
Yeah, pretty much.
I'm sorry, I miss Calvin Hobbs.
I really love, I'm really a big fan of the Foxtrot comics. Those are great.
Oh, those were a classic, man.
It's still going, too.
I still miss Bloom County, you know.
So that skip gets her defense to 140, evade to 82, and magic defense to 133.
Yeah, who would have thought bikini armor would actually be more practical than a full tiger suit, huh?
Just a second here. Okay! So since equipment's already tempered and everything, we don't have to worry about that. So now we're just going to go explore the town some more. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, they thought that was a different building.
Yeah, you know, we just want to do some dancing at Duck's new bar, you know?
This is NorthTown, capital of the Vandal Empire, which is a reoccurring empire in the town. Mm-hmm. Or, I mean, in the games. Or, games, there we go. So if you go downstairs, Watts is going to be down here. And this is pretty much where you can hang.
You're pretty stinky.
Make yourself at home. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. Oh, baby. There's a funny joke. Do you remember the Go-Lords from Saturday Night Live?
Yep.
Yeah, I always loved that when they had the Bill Clinton. The Bill Clinton. Oh, here we go. Hold on. I'll play this segment here. You turned in quite the swordsman. What brought this up? Oh, it's nothing really. I just had noticed how much more mature you become. That's all. Oh, well, thanks. The monastery made the right choice on its wielder. You know, I think I can do what I set out to do. That's the spirit. Now we can just stop wandering around lost all the time. This could go smoothly. Aw. Congrats, but Sis has been with you this whole time, right? How much stronger is she gonna get? Frighteningly strong. I'm sure you don't mean that in a bad way, right? One dream of it.
Yeah, praising head pass so, motherfuckers now.
They had a Bill Clinton doppelganger. I loved how they were trying. It's like, I can't tell the difference between them. So it's like, I know. Do any of you find this woman attractive? And he holds up a picture of Paula Jones. So the phony's like, oh, it makes me sick to my stomach. And then the real one's like, oh, baby, oh, baby. And his head just starts 360-ing. It's hilarious.
Wait. My favorite was the one with the ex-presidents where Bill Clinton wanted to join. He had a big-ass gimp suit.
Oh, yeah. Let's see if we got... Oh, more plot. Yeah.
Ooh, the plot's going to give us plot.
I can't believe we managed to sneak into the Empire. That was not fun. I was on the edge worried we'd get caught any second, but it was thrilling in a way. Thrilling. You better be careful when setting paw on the Empire. Okay, Neko. Hey, who's there? That's me, Neko Meow. What are you doing here? Just passing by and smelled your money. I mean, my favorite traveler's Meow. The Empire's not a friendly place for a cat trying to make a living. Soldiers keep throwing me and getting out of my tail. I've been chased out of most establishments in the world. Let me tell you, Mew. All I've got to show from efforts is setting up a shop that has a lot of rotten fish. But now I've found my favorite travelers. Maybe Mew can help me. Won't you buy some of my wares? It'll help. Hey, that vermin's come back. That is my perfect plan. I'll see you later, Meow. What was that all about? Good question.
Come back next time, Meow.
Meow.
Think this is funny, Meow?
Now set it down, Meow.
And for those of you who don't know, yes, we do like Super Troopers.
Fuck yeah.
Canada's greatest gift, the maple syrup chugging scene.
No, it's your birthday. Alright. See if there's more plot. Oh, we did it all like I kind of figured. Okay. So we're going to go around town and talk a little more, and then we're going to go grind it.
Whew, any more plot, and we'd be accused of being bronies, you know what I mean?
Wow. How could they possibly do this?
Yeah, let's just say there's some pretty disturbing OCs in the brony community, you know what I'm saying?
You know, every community's got disturbing people. Even the old classic ones.
Let's just say the Sonic and the bronies kind of give me the cringes, you know?
You should see my MS-DOS group on Facebook, my god. Some people in there, some fellas in the castle were gabbing about sunken treasure compared to the whole reef of the south. I mean, you know, some of those people are like, you know, SJW, like, oh, this guy's being toxic, and then it's just an argument between calling a computer or a rig, and saying, like, rig is for immature children to call it. It's like, I am kind of defensive. I call them rigs, but I'm not going to get butthurt about that guy thinking that. Don't let bad thoughts consume you. Keep your chin up. That's the ticket. Oh, yeah. That's the ticket to weed.
Always stay on the bright side of life.
A girl named Pamela gave me some candy. She said I could get more if I followed her to the ruins. Oh yeah, that's totally non-suspicious whatsoever.
Yeah, I'll give you a lift in my windowless van.
And there's Granny, what the guy was looking for, unfortunately. A little
one.
The resistance will take their base with them. We'll find it. Mark my words. Read.
Okay.
But first, I need to go get a drink at that nice cafe with the cute girl.
Now here's the big family here. Jeez, your family is so big, it's nightmare just making dinner. God, you had sex like, what, three times?
Mama!
Is dinner ready yet, Mom?
Mama!
Why is the Emperor fixated on the rest of the world? They say I have to worry, but I'm genius. We have a big family, how can I not? They got the biggest house in town, too.
Yeah, Ben must be doing something right.
So, yeah, we'll talk to the little girl first. Lately, there haven't been any balls at the castle. My sister's going stir-crazy. Oh, dear, I don't have anything to wear. What if there's a party at the castle tonight?
Apparently she likes to play with them balls.
Hee-hee, yeah, Tom.
Yeah.
There's only two beds there, so I wonder who sleeps with who, you know?
Dear, come into bed with Mommy. It's time to go to sleep.
Boy, no kidding. Ara-ara.
Oops, sorry.
Oh, whoops. No, that was me.
Oh.
But you talk to that guy, he'll tell you this is the Emperor's Castle, so... Alright, so we're gonna grind it here. I'm gonna be casting spells up the wazoo, basically, so... Well, I guess we'll start with Gnome. Let's play level one. Okay. And he's already busted jump to two. Well, that was nice. Yeah, this song's awesome, too. This is the Emperor song. So, not only do we level like we just did there, let's come on closer. There we go. That's not still epic. Come on closer, man. There we go. Oh, geez, the knight still doesn't. There we go. Let's see if this will cast it. There we go. Street knight.
You are not a knight to remember. That's for sure.
Alright.
Athreka.
Earthquaker. So we're going to be going back and forth here, basically, doing some ye old grinding. Yippee!
I speak of the English very good.
Oh, you let the fuck out of the Asian woman in the ass?
I learned the English at the Kojima School of American.
Alright, let's slow him down.
Can love exist on the battlefield? It could if you could speak English properly, Mr. Kojima.
Damn you!
Damn it, Colonel. I can't understand Moonspeak. We're gonna have to get somebody who can speak stupid. Hey, Otacon, we need an Anbu translator. Oh, fun fact about myself, people. When we go to the anime convention, I'm the anime interpreter. Because I know all the weird new shit.
There's this really hilarious Lakoya meme from this Kobayashi's Dragon Maid, where basically it shows her head, she's pointing her finger out, and she says, your mom doesn't pay for the internet for you to masturbate to anime, or to masturbate to, or the interwebs to masturbate to anime women.
Oh, one of my personal favorites was, well, the one where it shows you, like, you were supposed to slay the dragon, not lay the dragon.
Oh, I got that one. And the dragon, it's like, Papa, yeah. It's like half human, half dragon. That was great. You know, the real dragon's all grinning down.
The funny thing is, that actually did happen in the anime Dragon Pink, where he was, the main character, Pink, was a half dragon, half human, because the king sent his best dragon slayer to kill the red dragon, and he fell in love with her and had a kid with her. Yeah, Dragon Pink was like, what would happen?
That's a hentai, dude.
Yeah, well, it's
you're doing a Dragon Half.
Oh, Dragon Half. Yeah. Okay, sorry.
Yeah, I'm like, Pink's a kitty girl. What are you talking
sorry,
about?
Sorry, I got the shit mixed up.
That's how old I've been watching hentai. Jesus Christ.
But yeah, like, Dragon Half is like basically what happens when Deadpool and Otacon work together to make an anime.
Yeah.
And it gets an English translation for some reason.
Alright, going to level 3. Okay, now what I want to check is to see if I can get to level 4 with him right now.
Kicking and screaming won't get there yet.
Try this again here. Oh, good, it does. Perfect! Okay. Just what I want to see. Sounds like he says yippee-ki-yay. Yippee-ki-yay! Earthquake! Alright, we got them all there.
Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
Best one's from Die Hard 2 when he throws the lighter down on the fuel trail. Yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker.
You know, it kills me that Bruce Willis is a bigger badass in his late 50s than he was in his prime. And if you want to see one of the best Bruce Willis action films of all time, or hell, just one of the best action movies of all time, watch R.E.D., Retired and Extremely Dangerous.
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
Arguably one of the best action movies I've ever seen.
John Malkovich's paranoid character in that was classic.
You know, when we saw that scene with him staring down that CIA agent, and he said, "You smell like Washington," me, my mom, and my sister all looked at each other and we said, "Dad." First words out of our lips, "Dad." Yeah, my dad was a little bit of a weirdo.
Didn't the sofa talk to him a lot?
You know, I can't remember.
Or I thought that was either your grandfather or your dad, one of the two.
Yeah, I can't remember which family member it was.
No, it's a good thing that Ardith actually turned out to be the sanest one out of them all.
I know, right? And I know that's a damn faint phrase coming from my family, but hey, I'll take what I can get.
Well, Boku subscribed to my channel yesterday, and he'll be joining us for recordings and games and whatnot. Be on the lookout for James Bond movie reviews from the both of us, because we're diehard James Bond fans, so I'm really looking forward to that.
Now, the only question is, are we going to have vodka or dry martinis, you know, for the occasion? I just need a little advance warning, you know, how shit-faced are we going to be for this?
How shit-faced are we going to be?
How drunk are we going to be for these reviews? Are we going to be Charlie Sheen, or are we just going to go, like, full Gary Busey?
Alright, so...
I just, I need to warn my liver in advance.
Okay, I have one more level to build on this, and then I guess we'll go work on Undine next with Weasel! Yeah, this is not only a good way to build up your spell stats, this is something that you should always do. If you want to do grid leveling, make sure when you get to this point of the game that you do this. Whatever level you end up at is whatever level you end up at, but make sure that you get your current spells up to 4, and Cure Water at 4 for sure. But not only does this level up spells, but this levels up your characters, and you build gold up later on, because right after the Empire, you want to make a beeline to Gold Island and actually get that equipment early. There is equipment you can get in the Lofty Mountains in Mandala, but the battle armor equipment that's over on Gold Island is way better. So that's just something you want to do. We'll go over that again when we get to that point of the game, so don't want to spoil too much. But yeah, definitely do this here. Make sure that you're over, like, at least level 30 or higher as well. And there we go. So we got Gnome to level 4 at this point. So now it's time to Frieza! Alright, so she got to level 30 as well. Okay, take a swing at me, punk. There we go.
So that means we're up.
Frieza! And use fairy walnuts too to recover your magic. You can just buy more with the gold that you get and everything, so no biggie. Sleep at the inn when you're done though, and you know, after you buy them, so don't waste a rest and then whatnot, so.
Yeah, because, you know, you gotta support your local sleazy cat merchant.
There we go.
Gotta feed the kitty.
I was hoping in this remake that Neko was going to be hiding out somewhere after that cutscene, but no, you don't see him again until you get to the Lofty Mountains, unfortunately. So. You figure like, hey, please program yourself into the game.
I'm sorry, but now you can't have a cat orgy.
You're having a cat orgy!
No, please, it's not Papa!
Don't get it!
Wait. Hey, you guys, I'm out of here.
For you guys, I'm going home.
You know what the funniest thing is, and I'm not even shitting you about this.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh, I was scary. I was like sitting there like, what the hell's going on here?
There's actual multiple instances of fan art on Gelbrew of Moko no Fujiwara dating Kenny McCormick from South Park.
Really? And who's that chick from?
She's the immortal Phoenix girl from Toho Project. The one with the white hair and the suspenders. Yeah, the funny thing is her girlfriend, the only school teacher in Gensokyo, is a massive lesbian and pervert who keeps trying to find excuses to dress her in cute girl clothing.
I was wondering what was going on there when the game froze. I'm like, don't fucking do this!
Don't pull a Bethesda on us. I'm sorry, Mr. Warburton, I can't let you run New Vegas today.
Hey guys, shut up!
Sorry, Jim.
You know what the funny thing is? There's an actual character in DC Comics called Detective Chip, who's good friends with Batman and John Constantine. I'm serious. He has a Bat Cow, a Bat Dalmatian, a friend who is a super intelligent Detective Chip who knows magic. You know what Batman is? He's Barbie. He has everything. He is literally Barbie.
Klaus Barbie.
Oh my god, I just beat Matt Pat to the stupid Batman theory. Praise me! Could I be a member of the game theorist now, Mr. Matt Pat?
We've got a little more.
Oh, okay, sorry.
Well, I guess that didn't happen.
Do I now get to make stupid math theories too? Yeah, seriously, when are we gonna see the Five Nights at Freddy's and Chuck E. Cheese crossover?
Oh dear lord.
Inquiring minds wanna know.
God save the queen.
Or hey, here's the ultimate way to destroy the internet. Five Nights at Freddy's versus Undertale, the video game.
Oh dear lord.
Or Five Nights at Freddy's versus Undertale versus Rick and Morty.
I can't believe the Rule 34 fan base of Five Nights at Freddy's. It's very disturbing.
Oh my god, the Rick and Morty stuff is even worse.
I don't even want to venture into that crap there.
I mean, people, I am not even joking you. I have watched every episode of both Japanese and English dubs of Yumaneko Nanako Korni, Higurashi Nanako Korni, Elfin Lied, the original Berserk, and I can't even watch 3 minutes of the shit I see from the Rick and Morty family. I mean, do you have any idea how violent Yumaneko is? I can watch that shit. I cannot watch Rick and Morty fans. Even I have standards.
Yeah. I mean, it's got some clever jokes in it and everything, but the fan base is just, like, extremely toxic.
It's like, you know, I have a bad need to hold on to my sanity and my rationality. No thanks. If I want to rape my mind, I can find better ways to do it.
Rape your mind. LOL.
It's like, look, if I want to get mind-fucked, I know where the Cthulhu is. It's like, don't mind me, I'll be hanging out with the Yellow King, thank you very much. But yeah, Rick and Morty is like the only thing that can cringe harder than some of the My Little Pony fandoms.
Yeah, the Brony fandom is really divided, I've noticed.
You know, it was kind of the same way with like the Axis Powers of Talia. You had the really smart ones that knew their geography and history, And then you had the people who just wanted to see Germany fuck everybody. I mean, seriously, people, I realize you want to say America is evil, but America would not fuck in Germany after World War II. You know what I'm saying?
No, I'm saying, yes, I know what you are saying.
I mean, it just scares me how they're like, how they will try to ship anybody with anybody. It's like, I realize you think it's cute, but Japan and Taiwan are not that close. Now, Japan and Turkey, on the other hand, that's a different story. It's like, you want to ship Turkey with Japan, go right ahead. But Taiwan, that's a bit of a stretch.
Nice.
Also, right. Big Brother China would be very, very upset. 4,000 years of Chinese history is about to punish your ass, little brother. Ooh, kindly, kindly, Onichan. I'm sorry.
Never speak senpai.
Yeah, really. Oh, speaking of that, Patrick, have you ever heard of Transformers the Kiss Players? It was a Japanese-only manga edition.
Why did you use my middle name?
Oh, sorry. Sorry, people, I spent a little...
That's okay, Jose. No, it's not his middle name, but it's okay.
Eh, close
just
enough.
Just call me Snake. No, that's Fox.
Yeah, I spent a little too much time in the sun
today.
What are
you doing?
Oops.
So what are we gonna do next, man?
Well, I mean, we could potentially go outside and scream bloody murder and see if the cops actually show up.
That's it, back in the garage.
That's it, Artif. Back into the basement.
Yep. Back in the garage. Bobby, what are you doing out of the garage?
But I don't want to spend more time with Hillary.
Oh, dear. Yeah, because if you do, you might end up committing suicide.
Yeah, because, you know, it's totally normal to shoot yourself in the back of the head 2 times.
It's totally normal to kill yourself on the center of a dance floor. You know, after investigating the Clinton Foundation and everything, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you know, everybody kills themselves by shooting themselves in the head 2 times, rolling them up in carpet,
it's
taking
like,
a bus, and then moving to a different location.
It's like that line in Casino, you know, it's just like, every time somebody talks to me, everybody wants to know, do I know you, and everything. Every time my name comes up, so it's like, every time the Clinton Foundation comes up, suicide comes up with it as well.
It's, you know, it almost makes you have to wonder, how many cemeteries do they have to fill before they become a Batman villain? I'm just saying.
Wow.
Because, I mean, come on, let's face it. At this point, Hillary's probably got a bigger death count than the Joker. Now look, Batman, I know you think I'm bad, but just think about this. I'm not Hillary Clinton, okay? I'm just saying.
Oh yeah, right now I'm actually beta testing Ghost Recon Breakpoint. It's a lot deeper than Wildlands so far. I can't really say much because of this agreement I took and everything, but it's... Oh wait, what am I doing? Shit, okay, no biggie. But I gotta say, it's pretty good. I'm having a good time so far. So, it's got deeper RPG elements in it than Wildlands has. So again, I'm just going to be saying some things that aren't going to give away, like the game and everything. Visually, it does look better than Wildlands as well. It runs fine on my 980 Ti, which is really cool. So.
Now, he can't say he recommends the game, but I mean...
I flipped through some bridges, though. I mean, it's still in beta, so I understand, but I was laughing because I was riding a motorcycle, and I flipped through a bridge across a river, and I was just laughing so hard at that. I'm like, oh, yay. It's so funny. Every Ubisoft open-world game that has vehicles in it, like, or practically almost every open-world game has vehicles that just defy the law of physics and gravity.
Well, you know, they were just trying to do Ride to Hell Retribution, but do it right.
Sweet.
It's fine.
Alright, so that's been leveled, so let's go to Sylphid next.
Yeah, you know, he's just trying to get them up on their ACDC, you know? Get thunderstruck. Like Oaken! Yeah, by the way, people, I almost hate to mention this, but man, they really need to just let Benny Maru Nikaido wear his hair down, because he kind of looks a little stupid with the blonde kid and play look, you know?
The blonde kid and play flat top, yeah.
I mean, seriously, if you've ever seen him when he actually has his hair down, it's like, why are you being Mr. Eraserhead? We've already got a person who covers that look, and his name is Joe Higashi.
Joe is so awesome.
He is, man. He's a bro. You know, plus I love that canonically he's dating Lily Kane.
Yep.
Which is just so hilarious. I love that moment in King of Fighters 14 where if your first two fighters out are Joe Higashi and Billy, he's like, hey, Billy, have you seen your sister Lily lately? I want to talk to her. He's like, damn it, Joe, I'm going to kill you this time. It is just so cute that they reference that.
Uh-oh, Pinnacox.
Ah.
These guys are a little challenging. Well, let's cast Air Blast on the motherfucker.
Well, you know, at least it's not as bad as the Mimic Boxes from Dark Souls. That is bullshit.
That magic didn't even work on that fucker. Cool, okay.
Nice. We came, we saw, we kicked his ass.
Trucking.
Yeah, because you know we gotta show the girl character a whole new world.
Oh dear Lord, though.
Yeah, she kind of looks like Jasmine with blonde hair, and not having to appear in a shitty live-action remake with Will Smith.
Jasmine's the best Disney princess.
Mm. You will get no arguments from me on that one, Mr. Fox.
Boku also agreed with me last night about that too, which is great.
You know, she was in my opinion the most interesting Disney princess we ever got. Proactive, intelligent, clever, and a bit of a badass in her own right.
Oh yeah. She didn't bend over and take it like others do, so yeah.
I mean, you know, she really set the new standard for the Disney princess in my opinion. I mean, I kinda like Belle, but give me that Jasmine, huh?
Well, I like Belle for being a buckworm, so... Air Blast! Get the blast on!
You know, I forget where I saw it, but I remember there was a picture I saw somewhere of the girl from the anime Read or Die reading books at the library with Patchouli Knowledge and Belle from Beauty and the Beast. And it was the most awesome thing I ever saw.
Oh, Yoko Readerman, yeah.
Yeah. You know, I'm not gonna lie, I kinda had a bit of a crush on her back in the day.
It's the paper! Mr. Gentleman! Joker! Misty!
Plus, you know, they had the hottest version of Shadow Cat Kitty Pryde in that show.
Please return the book to me? Okay.
You know, there's just something so awesome about an awkward and nerdy girl who loves books. And then she busts out the nipple clamp from the ball gag.
Please return the book to me? Please? That's all you care about? You don't care if they're being bad guys? Okay. I love the opening theme song for the OVA of that. It's so awesome.
Oh, that was one of the
so
best.
It's like so James Bond.
Oh, indeed, man. I mean, that's like right up there with the Cowboy Bebop opening, man.
Oh, hell yeah. That's still the hands down the best anime.
Oh, hell yeah. 3, 2, 1, let's jam. You know, I love the parody of the Final Fantasy 012 Dissidium with the Cowboy Bebop opening. That was just so great.
Hey,
Ernest
F32.
Oh, and by the way, if any of you, for whatever reason, still own a PSP and you're gonna search down that game, word of advice: get some pointers before you play X-Death. You will thank your sanity and your thumbs later.
Oh, X-Step from yeah. 5.
Ugh. Void. The Void. For the Void. Everything is the Void. Why don't you and the Void go get a room? You know, I'm not going to say he was like the worst character and villain in that game, but I wouldn't argue with anybody who made that point for me.
The Final Fantasy V reboot that they did on Steam was god awful.
Ugh.
The dialogue in that was terrible.
And you know, it wasn't exactly award-winning dialogue to begin with. Just bear that in mind. Final
no,
Fantasy
no, don't,
V...
Don't knock him back.
Oh, sorry.
Because I gotta cast a spell on these guys.
I mean, Final Fantasy V was a fun game, but let's just say it's not as well remembered for good reasons.
Yeah, I mean, the job system was cool and all, but the plot was really just cookie-cutter BS, practically.
Yeah.
I mean, 4 is hands down my all-time favorite Final Fantasy. That was actually the second one I played, and I played it as 2 on the Super Nintendo, and that one blew my fucking mind.
Oh, heck yeah, man. I had the poor misfortune of having to start with Mystic Quest, but then Final Fantasy IV came in and,
Mystic Quest isn't that bad. I consider it an underrated gem. So, you know, it really isn't that bad of a game. It has a great soundtrack in it, too. So, careful with that.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'll tell you one thing, though. If you want to play one of the most one of the most underappreciated gems in Final Fantasy history, get yourself a PSP and check out Final Fantasy Tactics. Oh!
Yeah, I told you to be careful.
Sorry. Get a PSP and play Final Fantasy Tactics War of the Lions. Unfortunately, the PSP has...
Careful, up!
Oh.
Up! Get out of the menu and go up!
I thought I was.
You're controlling.
Oh.
Ah, man, we're gonna die again, dude.
Sorry. Let's see.
Up.
Okay. I did not.
Better cast some pure water on you, on all of us.
Sorry.
Okay, that's a relief there.
Keep forgetting the buttons are different. There we go. Mermaid waifu.
There we go.
Man, look at
at least that gives us a little bit of a head start on the pure water, and I guess they're going, okay. Yeah, those mimic boxes are a pain in the fucking ass. They do so much damage to you there. But it's no big deal. I mean, you know, we're building gold and everything like that, but it's just like, yeah, dude, you died. You're in control of the other guy, man.
But yeah, now, in Tactics War, in the original Final Fantasy Tactics, there was a really awesome character you only got, like, for the tutorial stage called Gap Garen, who had the most awesome class. He was a Shadow Knight. And there was no way to get a Shadow Knight in the original.
Oh, so we used up all the fairy walnuts. Okay, so we gotta go get some more, no problem.
But in the PSP remake, you actually can get a Shadow Knight. And they had optional side missions you could get in the taverns to recruit legendary characters from other Final Fantasy games. You could, for instance, get Balthier from Part 12, who, by the way, is the best character in Part 12. And yes, Cloud was in the fucking game, and you could get an additional
quest. But he's just so awesome! Balthier, he sends the greatest Final Fantasy ever!
And the worst part is they had Aerith there, and you had to do a quest to gather flowers to get his Buster Sword.
Like, literally every fucking person out there right now.
Final Fantasy VII Remake, oh boy!
Though the battle system looks interesting in it, I gotta admit that.
Yeah, although I am gonna kind of be a little sad to see the old turn-based system go. you know, just the
it's
old...
It's becoming the way of the dinosaur, but it still has, I mean, you know, it's stuff that you grew up with and everything, basically.
Yeah, plus, you know, part of the fun was seeing how much, how many bullshit strategies you could come up with to break the game using the in-game systems. I mean, that was part of the fun of some of those old games, was just seeing how many exploits and just other crazy shit you could get away with.
Where are you going?
Oops.
How many times today, Artis?
I don't know. How many times have you eaten bread, Mr. Fox?
What sounds good for dinner tonight, I wonder? I'll have to see how much money Pikachu has. But no, I've got money too, but we're splitting the bill, basically, so...
I've also got a little bit of cash, not much, though.
Oh, you're fine.
Yeah, I bought
One thing that you're going to want to make sure that you have, by the way, is you're going to want to make sure eventually that you get to 6 figures with your gold before you leave the Empire. Probably to be on the safe side, you're probably looking at 150 to 200K to be on the safe side there. So, and I know it doesn't look like, you know, we'll get there, but we will, because there's 2 quests that we have to complete here, and we're not going to be getting too much... you know, equipment after this and whatnot, minus replenishing on, you know, items there and everything. So, basically, you know, just keep that in mind there because, you know, when you get the better equipment and everything, it's expensive as hell.
Yep, even in these old school games with a better economy, money is still power.
Oh, damn.
Money, money, money. It comes money. I tell you, man, I miss the old days of stuff like Don Henley, the Eagles, and Michael Jackson blowing our minds with the moonwalk. Try all you want, Timberlake, you will never be like Mike.
Sweet, alright.
I wanna be like Mike. Everybody wants to dance like Mike. That ain't no new condition, kiddies. Michael Jackson, blowing everybody's minds since fucking ever.
Like Mike.
You know, how strange is it that there are 2 black men named Michael who are like the most insanely awesome people ever? One of them can fly and the other one is quite literally the god of dance.
And one of them's dead. Ooh, too soon?
Yeah, a little too soon.
He was actually born the day before I was, August 29th.
And now I'm even more jealous. Dead Fox!
Yeah, the better person was born on my birthday, Mary Shelley.
Creator of one of the greatest literary classics of all time.
And ironically enough, you know, they did that all... They were sitting around in a party doing a short stories, and she wrote it through that, and then expanded upon it, so... Had a contest with her fellow writing friends. Name a video game that my birthday is mentioned as a date.
Your birthday is August 31st, right?
Huh? My birthday's August 30th.
I can't remember.
Metal Gear Solid 3.
Oh! Arguably the best one. Seriously, that was such a baller fucking game.
Alright, so we got Soul Fiddle level 4, so now it's time, it's Salamandu time.
Oh, and speaking of Metal Gear, 2 of the most awesome videos on YouTube are of 2 different people doing the ocelot revolver gun spinning in real life. One is a white guy who did a fantastic job of it, and the other one is the actual guy who did the motion capture work for it, a former Japanese soldier by the name of Tornado Arata.
Oh, level 2 already, nice.
And may I just comment how ironic it is that in a country that has banned firearms from private ownership, The guy who did the motion capture work for Revolver Ocelot was Japanese. Just saying. But yeah, seriously, those are two of the most badass gun videos on YouTube. Ocelot, the proud creature, in the fruit on the low.
Okay, now we just gotta get Salamandu up to 4 and then we're all set there.
But I'll tell you this though, Revolver Ocelot's most impressive feat he ever accomplished, somehow still getting hired despite being the biggest traitor in military history. Seriously, how good is the person who writes his resume?
That's right, true.
I don't care what you're paying him, Revolver Ocelot. That person deserves a pay raise and free blowjobs. Because, man, how does he keep finding government work? You know?
Now, just kind of like in the current season of 24 that Zach and I are following. Got that going on for Keith.
Yeah, sometimes you just have to ask, like, how bad do you... How many people do you have to murder... Or how many betrayals of your country do you have to commit before the DOJ prosecutes? You know what I'm saying? Hillary, the bodies are starting to pile up. Did you forget to pay the cleaning man to end, clean up the mess? Damn it, Bill. I told you that it was your turn this time of the month. Bill, did you remember to hire the Mexican gardener to end... take out garbage.
You know, since we're grinding and whatnot, and it's a little boring, or it's all boring, quote unquote, and whatnot. You know, I gave a heads up to Arvik about Jessica Yaniv, and oh. I gotta tell you, that was just atrocious right there. If you guys don't know, he's that one transgender in the British Columbia area who basically was trying to get a Brazilian wax on his nuts and whatnot. So, like, all of a sudden, all these fucking left-wing, like, diehard left-wing sites were trying to defend it and everything. Like, you know, oh, you just want to get a smooth nutsack and blah, blah. But, you know, it's kind of like that whole haircut thing back then where it's like he wasn't good. He didn't know how to do a girl's haircut and everything. They only knew how to do boys' haircuts. And this one, it's like nobody knew. Like, the joke that I cracked was basically nobody wanted to handle his cock and everything. So as a result of it, you know, you sued him and got him put that place out of business, which was really, really sad there. But when he was confronted in an interview... Basically, he was trying to play this game where it's like, well, I'm protected under British Columbia, like the BC, like, you know, Fair Transgender Act and blah, blah. And I'm just sitting there like, yeah, but that doesn't give you, like, the right or permission to force. I mean, everybody else's too, you know. And when he was basically pressed upon that and asked if that was, you know, true and whatnot, he hung up on the interview on this one Irish news channel. It was fucking hilarious.
You know what the whole Jessica Yaniv scandal kind of reminds me of? That time in South Park when Mr. Garrison transitioned to Mrs. Garrison. Remember how obnoxious he was at that point?
Level 3, nice. Now wax my balls, bigot! I mean, seriously, if you're... And it's just like the whole gay cake thing and everything like that. There's so many different bakeries out there and whatnot. You have to go to a Christian bakery and demand that a cake be made for a gay wedding. You know, that's ridiculous. There's like so many other bakeries that'd be more than happy to do it for you. That's when you know at that point, this is just like staged bullshit, basically, to oust people. I mean, I'm not religious, but to oust somebody over their beliefs like that is just totally immature, basically.
Yeah, and isn't there that rule that every private business has a right to refuse service to a customer if they're being belligerent?
Well, so does YouTube and Facebook and Twitter and everything, yeah. But then, of course, when you're basically trying to create a platform to communicate freely between one another, and then you suddenly start putting restrictions on it, that's where your entire mission message just becomes basically hypocritical. So, yeah, it's not that anybody's denying that these are private businesses and everything, but when you're putting things up basically for fair use of trade and whatnot, you're going to get blowback from people. So you're going to get different types of personalities, and you're going to get sick people are going to be on it and everything. But as long as they're not doing a call to arms for harm or anything of that nature, who gives a fuck? But nowadays, of course, you know, calling somebody names and stuff is weaponized violence.
You know, if that's weaponized violence, then what's Mark Zuckerberg?
Zuckerberg.
Is that like intellectual and emotional genocide?
Yeah, that's, I like that. The shoe fits, Arden.
You know, we're gonna have to come up with a bullshit red pill euphemisms for this crap. That's gonna have to be a new hobby. It's like, you're gonna create bullshit word salad for us to put up with? We're gonna do it right back. Welcome to the age of equality.
Let me fuck your 8-year-old daughter, bigot.
Hey, she's not an
pedophilia is normal. Yeah, see, it's just disgusting how people are starting to defend like criminal activity and stuff for the sake of moral superiority, basically.
You're a bigot. She's not an 8-year-old girl. She identifies as a Boko no Pico. Yeah. What's the difference?
And then basically, I mean, it's just going to keep getting worse and worse. I don't know when it's going to end. I really don't. You know, everybody's just going crazy about things. Everybody wants to just stay. I mean, we're divided, you know?
Yeah.
And we're going to stay divided. And I get lulls out of it, don't get me wrong. I think it's just fucking hilarious what people get offended at these days. But the reality of the matter is that it's just, I mean, in the end, nobody is going to come to compromise or anything like that, so...
It's, you know, it's one of those things that's like, you apologize first. You apologize first. I double dare you apologize first. I triple dog dare you to apologize first. It's like, dudes, let's just have Mr. Fox over here slam their skulls together and see which one comes to the right decision first. You gonna keep being stupid, or am I gonna have to use your heads of maracas? All I'm saying is just give us a couple of M32 grenade launchers. I think we know how to solve this problem. Yeah, we'll just go full Division 2 on it, you know? Roger that, Mr. Fox. I see some stupid approach in your area.
Over. I'm like sitting there like, what the hell am I doing?
Yeah, he's got to feed his crippling walnut addiction.
Walnut.
Walnut. It's what's for dinner.
I wish that the cursor would put a memory on. Thank you. Thank you so much there. But anyway, no, it's okay, man. But I wish they had put like a memory cursor on the spell that you were using last, because I'm sick and tired of like twisting over to that.
Yeah.
Oh, there's two of them still there. Don't poke them. Ah, thanks.
Sorry.
Told you not to do that for the fourth time! Alright, anyway, it's all good. We got it anyway.
I've got a raging murder clue right now.
Oh, my clue pointing this way. Oh, let's follow your clue. Alright, let's see. Oh, yeah. Let's go buy some walnuts, and let's go save and rest, and then we're going to go tackle the ruins. Actually, we're going to go level up pure water to 4.
There's walnuts inside your pouch.
What are you trying to want to sell? So as you can see, we're at 73k, so it's possible to get up to 150 and everything, especially with the hell that we're going to be going through soon. But it should be a little bit easier due to the fact that we're leveled up, you know, we went from 28 to 33 in this video, so far.
Yeah. No, thank God we're not
trying to... Relinquish control of the girl, please.
Oh, sorry.
No, you're fine. You were saying?
Thank God we're not trying to do something monumentally stupid like try to play Fate Grand Order online. Or, you know, like trying to roll for a magical cock wizard because there just ain't enough money on planet Earth.
Good, okay. That's lovely, you know?
It's like, what do you want from me? How much more do I have to sacrifice for my Scottish thigh master? You want my kidney? Can I give up my liver? Rip out my heart, woman. Give me my Scottish thigh master. You know, other people would be happy to die between the thighs of Chun-Li. It's like, give me the invincible god-slaying queen of the Shadow Realm. I'll show you, thigh master.
She always did like a good squeeze.
Indeed. I mean, hey, who else would be able to tame the Hound of Duskot? You know what I'm saying? You brought Ireland's Child of Light, motherfucker. I brought the Jug that conquered the Shadow Realm.
Oh, we're making progress. That's good.
You brought a Mario. I brought a Bowser. Mamma mia!
I always loved it when in The Simpsons when they made that episode where they put Mario in it on this Italian tour and he makes fun of Homer and then he turns into Donkey Kong where he jumps up in a treehouse and starts throwing the barrels down at Mario.
Oh, you want to hear something funny? In Borderlands 2, there are two bosses in the late game dedicated to Donkey Kong. There's, I forget what the first one is called, but it's like this super giant four-armed mutant gorilla. I think it's, I forget what it's called. Then there's another one that's a lot smaller, but it throws barrels at you, just like Donkey Kong does. And you can actually get one of the best rocket launchers in Borderlands 2 from the big one. He's pretty easy to farm. At one point, I had like five of the bottom moves in different elements.
So let's take a rest here. We're halfway done the leveling up Pure Water to 4, so that's pretty cool there.
So yeah, you know, if you happen to be out in the Nexus Badlands, just go get your Mario on and so you can get that badass rocket launcher you've always been wanting.
Alright.
Nothing says justice like animal abuse against a giant oversized gorilla. Yeah, they actually have a DLC area called the Wildlife Exploitation Reserve, where they have this area where you can do like these 5 rounds against armies of the toughest monsters in the game. And the guy who's running it for Mad Moxie, Captain Cabaria, whenever you're fighting, he's like, it's not animal abuse if they're out to kill you. You can also get another fun rocket launcher for completing all 5 ways called the 12-pound cleaner. And the fun thing about it is it's a Mad Moxie weapon, and with Moxie weapons, if you kill someone with it, it will actually heal you for how much damage you do to the enemy. So try to imagine having a rocket launcher that does like 12,000 damage, and that's like the regular model, and you're killing people with it. And if you're playing the Gunzerker, who can dual-wield any weapon in the entire game together... Yeah, he can dual-wield any gun in the game. You can have, like, the, you can have the Ruby Pistol, which does elemental damage and will heal you. And then have something like the Heartbreaker, which is a shotgun, which only comes with fire element, which will also heal you.
I finished, Black Mesa, recently, but they didn't create the World of Zen yet. Apparently that's coming out next month, so basically we'll see how well they do with it. But, it's not too bad of a, remake, to be honest there. It's not like, I mean, you know, it's like 19 years later, there's an update for Half-Life. Holy cow, 19, 20 years later, alright. But it's really not that bad, you know, it's, they've updated the visuals with, like, the Half-Life 2 engine, and, they put some more better physics in it, there's female scientists in it, so it gives, you know, in this case, this is something where it's like, okay, good, you know, but they're not, like, trying to, like, emphasize on, gender wars or anything like that. It's just good to see that there's actually, you know, in this case, I can say, like, oh, good, there's actually women in this, you know, because, yeah, Half-Life 1 had a lot of dudes in it, practically. So,
bit of a sausage fest.
Yeah.
Yeah, fun fact, I'm actually going to be playing a female scientist in our Doom Life RP.
Gloria Freeman in the flesh, or rather, in the hazard suit. I took the liberty of relieving you of your weapons. They were, after all, government property.
Mrs. Freeman, I know we've had this. I know it's a precious heirloom to you, but I'm afraid crowbars are not standard equipment for this research facility. I'm going to have to ask you to leave that at home. Yeah, you know I'm totally going to be bringing the crowbar to work.
Oh, yeah.
But sir, Mommy always said the quickest way to a man's heart is through his stomach, and if that doesn't work, bust out the crowbar. And remember, children, any violation of the safety protocols in this facility, and you're going to have a little chat with my good friend, Elvira, a.k.a. Mrs. Crowbar.
Alright, so now we're just going to rest and save. So now Pure Water's at level 4, so that's going to give us some better healing now. And now we're going to go tackle the Eastern Ruins, so it's going to be more zombie busting time.
Ah, we get to be members of the STARS unit now.
Stars. Okay, you can take control of the chick again now.
I'll give you stars.
I'll show you a finger, Trebek.
Don't censor my art, Trebek. Yeah, would you look at that? The right, two scoops are better than one.
Two Trebeks. I feel like I'm in a Raisin Bran commercial, two scoops of fruit. Okay, so here we go again. And here's Pamela. Pamela, wake up! Are you okay? Shut up. I won't go back. I look at her happy here. Leave us be. What do you think of that, huh? This is your venture. Take me from you in the first place. We'll never be yours. What? But Pamela, that can't be. It feels good to come out on top. And she gets slapped. Knocked back.
Oh, yeah.
This isn't what I wanted. Let's get her to Chrissy's. Come on, sis. What happened? There's Chrissy. Chrissy, can you take care of our friend for now? It's a long story. Okay. There's a doctor sympathetic to her cause. We'll take her there. Thank you. Leave this to us. You go help
Dialek. Oh, dear God. She's a blue-haired girl, and she's having depression issues. She's going to become Sayaka Mickey for Pola Madoka Magica. All right.
So now there's a second floor that we can go on that'll take us to some chest that'll have orbs, basically.
Oh, is this the level with the boss fight I'm thinking of?
Which boss fight?
The Lich?
No. That's the end of the game.
Oh, okay. I'm just waiting for that lynch fight, man.
And it's gone. Nicely done there. Okay. So there's those two doors, and I'll show you what we're talking about in just a moment.
Hey, boy!
We're also gonna find a sword orb in this place, which will get the sword to level 5.
No, no, I realize that I should be scary of you and your massive gables.
So here's the new bat sword.
Ah, shut it, kid. I don't have to take this from you.
They're called great bats.
Why?
Those little annoying guys are imps, basically. And they can vanish and reappear over and over and over again.
And they're also some of the biggest headaches you'll face in Castlevania, too.
Bats, yeah.
Fun times.
Well, let's torch these sons of bitches here.
Yep, the age-old answer to everything. Kill it with fire.
And as you can see, it was totally worth leveling.
It's super effective.
Blue drops have a good amount of hit points.
Just because they're slimes doesn't mean they don't lift, bro.
I'll just go through this way here. And I'll just take out these zombies and the tomato man.
Zombies, zombies, zombies. Yeah, funny thing about that song, that's actually about the war between Britain and the IRA.
Right, right. By the Cranberries.
And in my opinion, one of the greatest protest songs of all time.
Yep.
I mean, I still love war and what's it good for, but oh my god, that song is just beautiful. It's really heartfelt. You know, she's actually a pretty amazing singer and person in general.
And that's Spear Orb.
Oh.
So we'll go to the other side and we'll get another orb.
One step.
So yeah, definitely when you come in here, go up those staircases and go to the left and right sides and get those weapon orbs for sure. If you're going to be a completionist, that's what you want to do. Anyway, you're setting a level 34. Nice.
One step closer to becoming the 5-star SSR Lancer servant I've always dreamed of being. Yeah, that's right. Lancer Master Race, everybody. Keep your savers. Keep your sabers. Give me the Kukulins.
Alright, now we're going to use Exploder.
Explosion?
Do some more damage there.
Ah, Mr. Torg, and I have one question and one question only. Explosions? Boom. By the way, best character of Borderlands, hands down.
Very well, that won't fit. Watch it, Greg.
Boring. You want to hear about muscles, attacks, and guns. I love that guy. He's my spirit animal made manifest.
Nice, alright. And we got Artith up another level there. So his magic replenishes, which is awesome.
Yeah, you see, this is what we talk about when we talk about female privilege.
Grind it out.
But I'm not Sable from WWE.
Well, we're going to have to start the Ghostbusters 2 food chat here, and if you don't know it right off the bat, that's okay, but this is something we'll have to practice together. So what do you think? So what do you think of Chinese?
By the way, this wonderful meal represents the last of the petty cash.
No, I'm doing the Ghostbusters 2 one. So basically it's like Chinese, how about Thai, not too spicy, Greek, Mexican, pizza, thicker thin, Chicago. Yeah, Jess and I used to do that a lot, I remember that. Boku and I are going to be doing that now.
My personal favorite was the Twinkie slice. Imagine this Twinkie represents the size of the storage of the ghost in the storage containment facility. Now imagine this Twinkie being the size of the axis slice. That's a big Twinkie. It's like, hey Bankman, hey everybody, Winston Zedmore, he's gonna be joining the team. Great, charmed to meet you. By the way, tell him about the Twinkie. What about the Twinkie?
Oh crap, our best friend's back.
Woe and misfortune upon us.
Oh shit, he cast lunar magic on him.
Ah.
Yeah, all parties recovered there. But, at a cost, yeah.
Ah, frick!
Thank you for finally letting me freaking attack there. Alright, let's revive him here. Sorry, these guys are fuckers. It's not, and this time you didn't hold us up, so.
I think I need
yeah,
to heal.
Cast us all, cast it on all of us.
You treasure box.
Mimic box.
I'm gonna do to you what the Chosen Undead did to you in Dark Souls, motherfucker.
Thank you very much, Artith. You were awesome. Alright.
Right for the win.
Bless the fuck out. Anyway. Got the level 4 in his axe power there.
Go. It's time to gently ease these motherfuckers of the past.
Perfect. Ghosties.
You know, this is the only reason why people might have the right to say that Michael Bay knows what he's doing. Got a problem? Blow it up.
Move our way.
Critics can't argue with you if they're dead, after all.
Move over to the wall.
Sorry.
Come on, look what I'm trying to do here. Ah, what the hell, we'll do the lava lamp again. Alright,
let's get the hell
out of here because these ghosts are being jackasses.
Do we need to give you the laser room, mini-me? Those things kind of remind me of the peepee knives from Castlevania.
So we got another chest here. And a bow orb. Mm. Alright, so that's it. Now we can start going through everything. But of course, you know, always grind and always fight. That's the point of playing this game.
Yep. It's just not real justice if you don't kill everybody. No, it's not a scorched earth approach, it's just a urban redevelopment plan. No, officer, they're not terrorists, they're just volunteer, they're a volunteer FEMA organization. Antifa, volunteer FEMA, what's the difference?
I actually pressed my barefoot on a woman.
Which is almost, but not quite as painful as walking barefoot on Legos.
Oh, yeah.
Memories of childhood. And on the
eighth. Thank goodness.
I had a feeling we were going to need healing. Ah, jerkwads being jerkwads. Suck Lance, evildoer!
Thanks for spelling that magic there. Gee, what great debate you have! Finally, my god! Finally!
You know, it's almost like we're fighting Carl Lewis on bath salts.
As you can see, it's nothing we can't handle. Unfortunately, these suckers have a lot of aim.
There can be only one! Yeah, I love how the Demo Knight says that if you go full Demo Knight in TF2.
Cool. Alright. So down we go, and into the center door after we kill these bastards here.
Time for good little children to learn how to die properly. All the king's horses and all the king's men, there ain't gonna be enough universal healthcare to fix you again. Although then again, Obamacare was pretty bullshit to begin with.
Yeah,
I wonder if anybody's ever gonna do a consensus about how many people lost their homes and businesses because of that mandatory clause where you got, like, fines. I forget.
$695.
Yeah.
And it wasn't just that. I mean, there was, oh crap, another mimic box. We're running into these motherfuckers a lot. It wasn't just that. I mean, basically a lot of small businesses went out because they couldn't afford to pay their, their employees the healthcare benefits. It was just terrible to do something like that. So the point of a small business is to go into business for yourself
and provide an income to people that work for you and everything, and provide a product at the same time, and you're not like some mega corporation where you're, you know, giving people, being able to provide people benefits because you're making a gazillion bucks.
You know, that's
yes, I'm exaggerating, but still, you get the drift.
That's what I love about the current Bernie Sanders scandal.
Oh, Christ.
You know, he wants a... His $15 minimum wage proposal would be like a nuke on the economy, and yet he won't even pay his own employees $15
an
hour.
And what's even better is that in Seattle, businesses have gone, or small businesses have actually, oh geez, he got hammered by that movie bucks. Small businesses are pretty much going out the way of the dodo practically now in Seattle because of that crap that they pulled off.
You know what the funny thing I saw online before I got here was? There are so few real comic book stores left in North America, they can no longer use the old metric for measuring how successful a comic is. There's that, there are that, that's how many comic shops have gone out of business recently.
Oh, jeez. He just doesn't want to go away. He just keeps coming back.
Notice me, senpai.
Hey, very nice. Let's go.
Notice me hard.
Notice me hard.
In the bar.
Very long and very hard.
Deep Wang. Yeah, and have you ever played Shadow Warrior?
No, I haven't.
Oh my god. That is like one of the most hilariously over-the-top, stereotypical, almost racist video games I've ever seen. Oh my god, it is so good. I was watching Razor Fist play Shadow Warrior 2 on the Xbox, and I was just busting out laughing at some of... It takes the, like, stereotypes from Street Fighter 2, and it makes it look tame in comparison. I mean, Team Fortress 2...
God, I got rid of the red one.
Whoa.
Yeah, one hit, too. That was awesome. Pikachu's gonna be gonna be home in by 6 o'clock. It looks like, so that's cool.
Go for a level 4.
Very nice, and 35. All right. Oh yeah, now I got a 4 on that.
Nice.
Rock on.
Hey kids, rock and roll. Rock on. Yeah, we're a little old here on this channel. Can you tell?
I'll be 37 next month, so...
I'll be 43 in September.
Really?
I'm an old, old man.
I'm not that old.
They're Chobanhoods, Chobanhoods, in tight, tight, tight.
Yeah, we've been friends for 8 years now.
And you know, the sad thing is, that is probably the longest friendship I've had in my entire life.
Yeah.
Little sad to admit
that. Is, well, you know, actually, I've been friends with Boku for a very long time right now, so I think we're going on, 13 years now. It's really cool.
Oh man, I love that. That leaping stab. Kind of reminds me of a certain leaping stab you can do with the shield and lance in Monster Hunter. It looks absolutely epic if you can get a headshot in with it. Yeah, I actually pulled off a pretty bullshit maneuver against the Shore Gomagala yesterday, where I was using the Adept style in Generations, which, depended on the weapon, you can either do a perfect dodge or a perfect block. So I had the long blade, and I perfect dodged right through a shotgun explosion with no damage, and then I, like, came out the other end, and I nailed him right in the face with the long sword. And I realized, like, if you do an absolutely flawless perfect dodge or block, you can pretty much negate any damage that gets thrown at you. And if you time it just right and you're at the proper distance, you can get a pretty epic counterattack.
Alright. Survey's at 35 now, that's good.
So yeah, if you've ever wanted to go a full Genji Shimada against an actual dragon, frickin' go for it. Yeah, I was like, man, what do you know? Genji doesn't need healing this time. Yeah, I don't play Overwatch, but I love to make fun of it. But hey, who doesn't?
So, the sword orb's behind there, and we just gotta go find the switch to lower the spikes.
It's time to murder some bastards.
Right after these messages.
Same Fox time. Same Fox channel.
Same Fox time. Same Fox channel.
Oh my god, I called dibs on being the Riddler for that one. Yeah, I'm a bit of a Riddler fanboy.
I'm back here. Cheskar, let me help you get yourself.
Three bunnies. Damn. So
basically, we'll be going down around to this area here. Still being torched. Well, I think the cloud's not, yeah, that red cloud wasn't going to get affected by it. Oh, it did. Cool, okay. Oh no, it didn't. Alright, I thought it shrunk there for a second. Oh well. Because I was going to say, wait a minute. Fire worked against the fire cloud? What?
What a twist!
Yeah.
Yeah, my favorite bullshit strategy in video games was the battle against the Mimic Crystal in Final Fantasy V. Man, you want to talk about a real fucking FU to the player. For those of you who don't know, the battle against the crystal that holds the Mimic job class in that game, you have to go into a palace that's underwater on a time limit, and you have to do it, I believe, under 5 minutes, and how you beat the damn thing is you have to do...
You hear a noise in the distance, you have to do what?
And to beat the Mimic Crystal, you have to do absolutely fucking nothing, because it will mimic whatever you do. Yeah, how many people figured that out on their own first time with no strategy guide, you know what I'm saying?
Well, if the name Mimic Crystal says anything, but... Yeah.
Although the fight against Asura from Final Fantasy IV was pretty awesome.
That was a clever one.
Oh yeah.
When I was picking up on how she kept casting heal spells and everything, I'm like, I'm gonna cast Wall on her, and I did that Reflect or whatever, and I did that and boom, baby.
Yeah, that was one of the most clever and interesting boss fights in FF history.
Nice.
Just such a badass moment. Although I have to admit, the dragon quest you did for the Phoenix in FF5 was pretty cool too. If not a little heartrending.
Okay, so now we go down the staircase there.
Back off, Robin Hood.
And we push this switch. The door appears in the wall behind you, so it's like, yay, but don't forget what we were talking about before, right after this.
Oh, what were we talking about?
This game is sword or night. I was insane interrupting to you.
Oh, okay.
Wow.
Yeah, interesting thing I forgot to tell you about, your bae in a Fate Grand Order, Tamamo no Mai. You know how her first appearance was in the PSP game, Fate Extra. You know, the one with, like, the moon cancer and the computer simulation?
Yeah.
The archer in that game was actually Robin Hood, the Archer Green. And one of the funny things is, one of her new forms in Fate Grand Order, the Lancer one, actually has a noble phantasm where she basically drop kicks your balls from, like, low orbit. And the reason why this is a thing in Fate Extras, there's like a story moment where she thinks you're cheating on her, and earlier she did like an impromptu noble phantasm on Robin Hood where she basically nuked his testicles. And when she thinks you're cheating on her, by looking at, like, a Nero, Saber Nero, she threatens you with excessive crotch violence if you're unfaithful. Well, people love that joke so much that when they were doing the summer...
Oh my god, thank you!
That when they did the summer singularity event, which was basically an excuse to get all the girls in bikinis, they gave her a lancer form, and of course her noble phantasm is excessive crotch violence. Yeah, another weird thing is Frankenstein in that game is a girl, and her summer version is a saber. Also, her dad is James Moriarty.
Nice.
Yeah. James Moriarty cleans up his act, and he gets adopted by Frankenstein as her father. And he just goes with it, by the way. Yeah, when you kick his ass in the London Singularity, you basically recruit him, and Frankenstein decides just to make him her daddy, and he's just like, okay. It's kind of weird seeing, like, Frankenstein just basically decide to adopt a daddy for herself. And it's Moriarty of all people. It's just kind of weird, you know? Or the fact that in the Camelot Singularity, Ozymandias spends his whole time perving on Da Vinci-chan. Yeah, he even offers to become your servant if you let him have Da Vinci as his concubine. Yep. This is why
See,
I love
him. Artith has such interesting things to say every single time.
I find the weirdest shit, baby. Just for you.
There we go.
For your weirdness only.
Alright, so we're almost getting there.
Oh, dear
God. Just have to get through another little spike area, and then it's set, and it is our favorite drops of all time, the red drop. And there's even a fourth drop to him, but he's not as bad, ironically enough. You'd think he was, but he's still tough to hit, unfortunately. Well, I tell you what, let's freeze these bastards.
Yeah, how can a gelatinous pile of ice cream have such high evasion?
Boy, I'm kidding.
You know, maybe fat really isn't as unhealthy as we've been told if these guys are so fast.
Well, there's fats, well, you know, and there are fats that we do need to eat and everything, so... Especially when you're on a keto diet, which I'll be getting back on, starting next week, more than likely, so... Since basically Pikachu's back and we can start walking again, which is good. I've been doing the exercise bike and everything, but it just doesn't feel the same, unfortunately.
Yeah, there's nothing like walking with your friends out at night, you know?
Oh,
yeah. Plus, you know, you don't want to get those bad saddle sores. You want to stay back
there
from the cobblestones. I remember my mom told me a funny little joke about two nuns riding on a bicycle, and one of the nuns back of the chair says, "Oh, I've never come this way before," and the other one says, "Oh, that's just the cobblestones." Yeah, did I mention my mom likes to tell the funniest perverted jokes ever?
Alright, so we'll get out of here.
That's what I love about the Scottish folk group, the Corries, is they tell the most funny and interesting dirty Scottish jokes out of the job. Yeah, there's actually a funny one about two men who go out on a layabout. Which is basically like a man taking a girl into his car for a...
Why did you do that?
I did not see the door. Which is
we just beat the guys, too. We just... won.
Damn it, I would kill you if I didn't have to use the AI.
You know what's funny? We're actually beating them up a lot quicker than we did the last time, ironically enough.
But basically a layabout is like where a Scottish man and a girl go in their car for, you know, a nice little fun time. And they're both in the front seat, and he's looking at her, and he's looking at her, and she's looking at him, and it's like, hey, wanna go to the back seat? Oh, I don't wanna go to the back seat. Ah, would you like to have a drink then? Ooh, I'd love to have a drink. So, you know, he pours her a big glass, pours himself a wee one, and it's like, back seat then. Oh, I'm not going to the back seat. Ah, would you like to have another drink then? Oh, I'd love to have another drink. So, you know, he pours another big one, and he pours himself another wee-wee one. It's like, backseat then. Oh, no, I don't want to go to the backseat. Oh, would you love another drink then? Oh, yes, I'd love another drink. So, you know, he pours another huge one and another small one for her, and finally it's like, backseat then. It's like, oh, I don't want to go to the backseat. It's like, well, why not? It's like, I'm going to stay up here with you. Yeah, if you ever want to hear the funniest perverted jokes in history, go to Scotia, me son. Yeah, can you tell I've got interesting family members? By the way, the most badass version of Scotland the Brave is also done by the Corries. So, you want to get your Scotty on, baby? Go listen to some Corries. You won't regret it.
Baiting is driving nuts. Alright.
Candy
Wolf.
Level
36 now, so you press on this here.
Darn
it. In you go.
But and no now, sweets for the sweet girl.
Just keep going here. That's it for all the little stomping tricks and whatnot. We're almost to the first boss of this area, which is going to be a dear old friend of ours. Right around the corner, too, ironically enough.
Oh, and if any of you have a bit of a fetish for weird, nerdy musical trivia like I do, for whatever reason, if you've heard the song Moscow, Moscow by Dasgupta's Khan, they are not German or Russian. They're actually Swedish.
So now it's boss time. So look, it's the remade wall.
Oh, dear God. And now I'm having Final Fantasy XII flashbacks again.
So as usual, use the gnome, and he's much more powerful. Whoops, I used on the eye there, my there.
Leading glare.
Use it on the center, of course, don't use it on the eye. Because that'll piss the boss off even more.
I think I'm going to heal you guys real quick.
We don't need it.
Oh, okay.
We don't need it, yeah, we're going to get a free refill. After this is too easy of a fight to be doing that, dude. But thanks for keeping things in mind. See, we don't need to heal at all.
Oh man, you were right. This is...
Wow! So there's the cakewalk. This is why you want to build your magic up to 4. Not only get the extra levels in gold, but also kick ass against bosses.
Never question the fox. Way to go. Fist pump,
and there's
fist
the
pump.
Health recovery there. Yep. And obtain the whip orb.
Whip it.
Right, so
whip it good. Whip it into shape.
Now, we're at the altar where we've got all the dumb people walking around. And yes, they're dumb. So up we go. And here we go.
Well, at least they haven't hit Prime Clown World yet, you know?
Style look with red eyes. Style, last I missed you so much. Look, I'm so glad you're safe. Now her energy is being drained from her, and the sprite's just like. Traitor, what are you doing? That's the girl.
Fuck.
Where'd you send her? Bring her back now! The mighty Thanatos needed them. That he wants need of her. Or more specifically, her blood. How could you? You have no soul. Do you know how worried she's been for your sake? I don't care if you're under some spell, she loves you.
You just said it.
You've got too far, nice. Ouch, what have I been? No!
My waifu. I must protect my waifu.
Thank you, I can think clearly again. There's her blue eyes.
He's
still a Aryan guy. Our Aryan guy. Don't move, are you crazy? Please help Tyla, she's in terrible danger. There's a door behind the altar. Go!
Go get some rest, my Aryan brother. We'll get your waifu for you. Also, sorry.
Oh, there she is, and there's Thantos. No, Tyla! Ah. Oh, you should stick around. This girl's life force is stronger than I expected. She'll make a fine specimen. The what? No, this is impossible. How? She's revived. Where am I? What's wrong with you two? We can move! Now, up to Thantos, I see Dalek must have transferred some of his life force into her. He never fails to express all the more reason why we can't let him slip from our grasp. I have no more need for you fools. Vampire, do with them as you will. So this is the boss, the new boss.
It's time to get our Velma. Oh, I've got the imp, don't I?
What?
I've got the imp, don't I? The sprite?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on. There we go. Sure. Yeah, it's time to get our Belmonts on.
I got nothing to stand. He's got a thing out for him. Okay. So I think... You know what? I forgot. Cast Analyzer.
Okay. Let's see. That's Silky, right?
Yeah. I want to say it's known, but I could be wrong. Vampire looks awesome.
Yeah.
Oh, Lumina, yeah, okay. That's right, we don't have her yet, so... But I think if you use, Exploder on the... Oh, fuck's sake, there we go. Come on, there we go. Actually does fairly well. Yeah. Oh, he's being ripped on. I'm like, why are you not casting? I'm gonna cast Fireball. Yeah, I always used to consistently spam fire or salamander on him. Yeah, that's another reason why you level, because this guy can be fairly tricky, but he's not too bad.
Go for a charge attack. There you try to interrupt my charge.
Interrupted my charge just now. Oh, well.
Hard at this pace now.
God, the fucking evade, I swear to God.
Yeah, it's, looks like these guys have had a lot of practice. Well, you know, at least they're not getting their henchmen at Team Rocket R Us. At least somebody hired the right temp agency this time. Oh, I need to heal this sprite. Let's see. Explosion! Time to go full Eric Lacardi on a sorry ass.
There we go. Not the bastard.
Yes.
Did
You know what that character kind of looks like now that I think about it? Huh. The main, the boy? He kind of looks like a Mediterranean Axl Rose.
Obtain boomerang orb.
Welcome to the turkey. We got Danish trees.
Hey, Taylor. Taylor. Hey.
Hey,
we should go.
Thank you.
Don't worry, what matters is that he's alive. I'll find him again. I know I will. I know it. Yeah, you will, but unfortunately. Oh, wait, there's me spoiling things.
Well, you know what this means. She's on a never-ending quest to save her boyfriend.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh,
so there's
together.
No more enemies there. You use the magic rope that goes back to that balcony door there, but that's okay. This is just a hop, skip, and a jump down. Now, what's going to happen after this? Like, we're going to call it quits here soon, but what's going to happen after this? The leveling basically, you know, took a lot out, but that's okay. So what we're going to do next is just restock and then heal up and temper weapons. I'll have the Excalibur sword, which is awesome.
Excalibur!
And, basically, we're going to go, we're invited to the Empire to have like a, it's a, basically a peace banquet and everything, or so it seems. But we'll be doing that next time there.
But wait a minute, you can't have the Excalibur. I'm the blonde waifu with blue eyes.
Hint, hint.
You're drunk, buddy. All right, sell the chest right there. Now, chocolates. One fair walnut. Two cups of liquor. There we go. As you can see, we're at 114K now, so not too hard to get gold, as I said again.
You know, what an amazing NPC. Even a massive sale with these three kids can't break his dancing stride. Nobody puts NPC in the corner.
Now we're going to go ahead and temper weapons here. He smells like a war's a brewing in this town. Trust me, I've been around weaponry all my life. Alright, so now I've got the Excalibur.
Oh, that means Fox is now the king of all the Britons.
Titan Boomerang. Silver Bow. Silver Whip. Halberd.
Nice.
There we go. Alright, so we got all of our 10th tempered weapons. And now it's time to rest.
Well, I know I already made the Castlevania joke, but now you really can go full Belmont. Just gotta upgrade it to the vampire killer now.
Fine work today. Boss, help! Oh, I didn't see you there. No, what's wrong? I finally mustered up the courage to tell you. What's up, all in face? Is it another monster? Oh, right, monsters. But that's not why I'm here this time. It's the missus, that's what. Is this what about her? She's been sending me a lot lately. I mean, I'm happy to help you in the missus, but she asked me to run errands, give her shoulder rubs, clean her clothes. That's not my job description. Elementals can do menial tasks too? Huh, why didn't I think of that? Please have mercy, boss. No. Mrs. What brings you here? I didn't realize you were opposed to favors I was asking you. I apologize, gnome. Oh, well, that's alright. No harm done. Oh, that sweet tone sounds suspicious. He doesn't apologize. Maybe he's just gonna make Salamander her next party.
I knew it. I am evil.
Yep.
That pretty little face hides a monster inside. Hello, I'm ArthBay76. Would you like to be my waifu?
Wow.
Chris Hansen can't save you now.
Have a seat. Why don't you have a seat? Now, let's see if there's another story here. Oh, whoops.
Well, at least I can have a seat. Only if I can have a seat on your lap, Mr. Hansen. Why didn't you come here looking for no little boy, Buddha? I came here looking for a man.
Oh, boy.
Now, we can do this the easy way, or we can do it the hard way.
Crack the easy way.
Oh, I see. You choose the hard way. Yeah, Boondocks is a great show.
Okay. Well, that is that for now. So next time, we'll be going to the Resistance and talking about, oh, the Emperor wants peace, yay, and all that crap and stuff. So, yeah, we'll do that next time, and we'll be going over to Gold Island and another place and whatnot. And how are we going to get there, you ask? Well, you'll see. Oh, I had a lot of fun leveling up and everything. This is a pretty long video, too. But, yeah, this is great. This is GrayFox37.
This is the man who's going to jail 76.
And you guys have a good one there.
And now it's time to Alt-Z like a boss. So Alt-Z. Ah, there we go.